All right, today I have for you the secret compartment box. I'm only going to show the bottom today. It took quite a while to develop folding technique so that I could share it. It's pretty cool. It's got the secret items in it right now. And you can't see them. And they're difficult to get out. So here we go. You'll need a dollar. I've got a real crisp one so that I can show the folds as best as possible. And the secret compartment holds 4 dimes, which we'll put inside. Okay. So you got your dollar bill face up. You don't have to have a real crisp bill because it stays together really well. So you want to make the first fold across the top right under the United States of America. And I recommend laying it down, making sure it's nice and lined up, and then crease across, make it a real sharp crease. Now flip over and fold back right here where the green edge ends. Fold back so that just a little tiny bit of that's showing. There's little curves and points. So leave the points showing. So right there. I'm going to fold that back, and then they've got this line going all the way across, pretty much. Use that as your guide. Make it nice and straight, and lay that down. Now, right along the edge of this border of the back, fold it in. So that'll make a little bit of the top side black showing through. So we've got that fold and that fold. Now, unfold. Nope, don't unfold. So now right through this little line beneath the one. See the one right here? It's got a line right there and right there. Fold right along that line. So on the back, it'll show a little triangle, a little rectangle, and just the point of the one showing. So right along that line. It doesn't have to be exact. And crease that down. Can I leave that folded in and fold the bill in half? Line it up really well. Don't let any kinks happen. Right in here. Crease that down really sharply. Open up. Fold this edge into the center, the crease you just made. Crease that down. Open up. Fold this edge into the near center crease again. Nice and straight, line everything up. Okay. Open up. Now turn over. Now you've got the bill facing upright on the back. Unfold this just a little bit. And unfold underneath. Till it's sticking down 90 degrees like that. So unfold this and then find this first crease right here. Well, it's the second one because we've got the little partial crease right here. So go to this one, lift up, and bring that crease over to this edge. And flip over and crease this diagonal just up to this other crease. So you don't need a crease right here, just right there. And I'll leave that creased. And on the top edge here, fold this corner in, making a diagonal from this intersection crease up that way. So like that. So we've got a little tiny part of a box. Or if you open it up, this angle right here that we just made, make that crease right here. So just make a little crease right there. That comes in handy later. Now go to the second major vertical fold, lift it up, bring it over to this line. Don't let these slip. So if you have to, pinch a little bit right here so that it lays down right there. And we're making this angle crease. Crease that down up to this fold right here. See, we've got this line going across. And it about matches up with this line. Crease right there. Get the next one. Bring it up. And just let this relax up here so that you can lay this down. Flip over. Crease just that part to the edge. Up to that other crease right here. And then on the last quarter, fold the diagonal from here to right where this vertical crease matches that horizontal crease. So right here, this edge folds down to there. And you crease that all the way up to that crease right there. So I'm going to lay that one down, crease it really hard too. Okay. So now we've got it like this. And I had to actually write down instructions for myself on this, so let me look at them. Okay, so now take the bill, back side up. And right over here where we've got this little fold, unfold this corner. And make a fold from the edge of the paper at this vertical fold that goes up there. Over this way, we're just getting rid of this corner. It gets in the way later, so just fold it over and then fold that back up. Don't let the paper slip out. So that little tiny corner sticks out, that's fine. So put that down, crease that really well. So now turn the bill with the Eagle logo up. And let this side come back up. And now on this angle fold, fold it back like that. On the creases that are pre-creased. Now this angle fold, push over that way and lay this down like this on the inside, or from here, this vertical fold lays down right inside there. And then this angle fold we pull toward us. And just let this fold come in. Now this vertical fold, fold over this way, and this angle fold comes back this way. So now we've got that little tiny fold we made in the first place. Assemble that. And lay it in there like this. Now lift this part out. So you've got it like this. You've got it going really well. And lift this out and pull this corner to the front and this to the back. So we've got it like this now. And this extra overlap and this little tiny flap piece, short flap, we're going to open this up right here. See right here? And we're going to tuck it in there, leaving this corner on the bottom, this angle fold on the bottom, and this raw edge is going in here. The whole thing. So right in there. Keeping that corner inside. And so now you've got your box looking like this. Now, if you want to stash the dimes in or something else that is about this size, you've got the room of each corner to halfway across the sides of the bottom. So if it's a dime, you lift up the inside box. I almost called it the inside out box because there's no seams right here compared to my other box tutorials. So you just lift up the corner and you drop the dime in there in the corner. And then you go to the next one and you lift up the inside area and you drop your dime in there. Put it back down. Go to the next one. Lift up the corner, drop your dime in there, push it down, go to the next one, and lift up, and make sure you don't put it under here. Get this extra little short flap lifted up too, and drop your dime. See, there's the first dime, and we're going underneath. So now we've got all four dimes in there. Make sure none of them are overlapping each other. All right, all mine are nice and flat. Now this is the tricky part. A butter knife or a flat object rounded on the end, like a table knife, dinner table knife, will work good. And you just rotate it until you come to that little overlap edge right there, see, that we tucked under. And just get underneath there and lift it up over this outside edge of the box. And then kind of push this corner in as you go around. And we're getting this raw edge underneath here. So you see how it's going underneath? And just kind of push up here as you slide the smooth object. So lift this overlapping raw edge to the outside. And on the corners. You just gotta kind of push them in a little. There's two layers to the box, so you lift up a little bit if it gets stuck. And you just go around the edge and pry this way so that it comes out. And in showing you, I let this part slip out. But just go back. That can happen to you too. Push this down a little. Slide this along the edge. And see, it's coming around. A little bit came out. And now we're all the way back at the start. Lift this up over that edge. Well, here's the start. Lift that up over that. And the trick is to hold this down as you go with one finger here, one finger there. But once you get it in all the way around, it stays in really nice. And this part is pretty difficult. Mine keeps coming out. I'm gonna go around the other way now. Maybe that's better. As I said, I was having some difficulty making the best instructions for you. Oh yeah, you might have to like let the corners crease in a little bit to get it under there. That's the trick. There we go. Okay, so that part takes a little patience. But we've got it all together. And just go around and reassure. Reinforce the creases. And now we've got our box bottom with a hidden stash of 40 cents. But the cool thing is, when you pick that up, it's really interesting how it has some heft to it. And you can't really figure out too easily how to get the items out or what is in there. So I hope you enjoyed that. And I really like this box. I hope you do too. Recrease these corners a little. And then after I figure out how to explain how to make the top, because it's upside down, then we'll teach the top. And it fits on there. And it's a very unique box. I designed this about a month ago. So I got 4/27/2019. And finally went through the instructions very carefully. I even actually wrote them down to make this one because I had trouble myself folding it again and again. All right, now it's on video. We can all fold it. Have a great day. Bye.